Hi everyone, so this is the third lesson three, and it's sums to infinity. The idea that eventually get down to a point where I'm not adding on much else and I can add it up, I can add it as I go along, and I get this formula which is given in your formula booklet. So that's like a classic example that where I start off with half and then I half it, add it, eventually get the area of the block. So let's have a quick look at this example then. So I've got a sum to infinity, so hopefully you're okay to see that a is 1, and I'm multiplying by a third. And it's important to stress that it has to be between plus or minus 1, so the number goes down. So it eventually gets down to a point where I'm not adding anything up, and I can add up my sum. So the sum to infinity is a over 1 minus r. So the sum to infinity is 1 over 1 minus a third. So you can put it straight in your calculator, or just say, okay, that's 1 over 2 thirds, so it's 3 over 2. There. And there's one for you to do exactly the same. But be careful with this one, because you're multiplying by it minus a half. Hopefully that'll show. There we go. Dead simple. Boing. Right, let's have a look at this one then, example 2. So it says the second term of the geometric series is 16. So we know that U2 is 16. So 16 is equal to AR, second term. And the sum to infinity is 100. So the sum to infinity is 100. So 100 is a over 1 minus r. So I've got to find two possible values for the ratio and the corresponding first terms for both of them. Right, so we need to put one into the other. So it's entirely up to you how you do it. I'm going to change this into 16 over r is a, and I'm going to replace that there. What it will do is it will put the r on the bottom, so I've got like 100 is 16 over r, 1 minus r. So what I've actually got is 16 over r, lots of 1 minus r. Now I've got choices here, but I might just take that up there. So I've got 100 r, 1 minus r, is equal to 16. So I've got 100r minus 100r squared is 16. So 100r squared minus 100r plus 16 is my polynomial. Gives me r is a fifth or r is 4/5. So they're okay, that's brilliant. Because we've got the modulus of r is less than 1, that's fine. So we wanted the first terms, didn't it? So if I use r is 1/5, I'm going to use 16 over r is a, then I've got 16 over 1/5 is a, so that's going to be, what's that going to be, 80, isn't it? So that's going to give me an a value of 80. And then if I used r's 4/5, that's going to get me 16 over 4/5. The 4 cancel, times 3 by the 5 gives me a 20 or a. There. And that's that question 3 then, isn't it? Because I found the two possible values and the possible corresponding first term. So there's one there for you, same idea. Oof, but it's got the sum this time. So yours is a little bit harder. There. So I'll put one into the other and see what I get out. Right, let's have a look at example 3 then. So it says the nth term of a geometric series is that. State the value of the common ratio in this thing. So, that's another thing. I've lost my cause, Martin. It says. So if n is 1, so if n is 1, I get 48 times a quarter, which is going to be, what's that going to be, 12, isn't it? So, there's 12, but then if n is 2, then I'm divided, so I get, so u2 is 3. So, I'm kind of multiplying by the water to get their answer. So, state the column ratio. So, that must be a quarter for r. So, r is a quarter. So the first term is 12, the second term is 3, got to be multiplied by a quarter for that, haven't we? So I've stated the common ratio, I've done that, find the sum to infinity. So my sum to infinity is a over 1 minus r, so it's 12 over 1 minus a quarter. So I've got 12 over 3 quarters, that's going to be 16 out of the answer, isn't it? Sum to infinity is 16. Okay. And then it says, oof, oh no, not one of these. So this one says it wants the sum from the fourth to infinity. So I kind of do, I kind of show it with a block, but the idea is, well, I can do it with a line, I guess. There's your first term, there's your fourth term, there's your infinity term. I want from the fourth one, oops, let me check it out. I want from the fourth one to infinity, which means I need to get rid of the first three. So the way I do it is the sum to infinity, which does from the first to infinity, minus the ones I don't want, which is the sum of the first three terms. Everybody gets that wrong. It's one of the worst answered questions in the paper. So I'm going from the fourth to infinity anyway. So my sum to infinity is 16. I need to remove the first three terms. So that's going to be 12 a quarter cubed minus 1 over a quarter minus 1. Now if you look, my r value there will give me a negative on the top and bottom. So it's better if I wanted to not use that one and switch it. So if I didn't want to use this equation, I could use the other one, which is 12 watts of 1 minus a quarter cubed over 1 minus a quarter. To be fair, if you're kind of like, you know, if you're careful with your calculator, it's a minus and a minus on the top, so it'll sort itself out. And you should get out a quarter if that works. There's another example, so there's your choice really, but that's my choice. Gotta push that choice, it's up to you which one you want. There's another example, so I'll start another.